You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, presented by the Only One Media Group. This is the people's choice for quality interviews, celebrities, and special guests. Hosted by Demetrius Dinny Reynolds. Call in to join the mix at 701-801-9813. For the complete archive of episodes, visit onlyonemediagroup.com and be sure to like us on Facebook at Vigilantes Radio. We welcome all. Enjoy the show.
Hello, hello, hello. What is going on, guys? Welcome to another incredible episode of Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio. And I am your host, Dini. We have a very special stick around for that. And as a matter of fact, text your buddies, family members, or even share it on social media right now and let them know that we are about to dive deep into another interview. Before I bring my guest on, I do want to say that you have to choose to ignore the little annoying behaviors of others, and no one will be able to annoy you. Annoyance, after all, is in your mind. Choose to be free from worry and anxiety, and your moments will instead be filled with the purpose and joy. You're like, Dini, what are you talking about? You're not living in the real world. Yeah, I get it, but sometimes you gotta choose to see the beauty in people, and you'll find yourself surrounded by beautiful people. Choose to make the best of every situation, and your days will be filled with positive achievements. You know, choose to learn from each experience, and your wisdom will become more profound with every passing day. I know my days are not all kumbaya, I promise you that. But sometimes you just gotta choose to seek out and enjoy the difficult challenges. And you'll find yourself, you know, growing stronger each and every time. It's like, oh yeah, I survived this one too. Yeah, I'm still alive. Yay me. You know, choose to make a positive difference, and the good things in your life will increase in quantity and in value. Each day is a choice. Each moment is a choice. Always remember that your attitude, your outlook, your perspectives, your commitments, your thoughts, and your actions are all choices. Choices which can make an enormous difference and the way your life proceeds. Take that from me, Coach Dini. That is my word, and word is bond.
Have you struggled budgeting your finances? Don't worry, you're not alone. Humbledbudget.com, that's HumbledBudget.com, is the help and resource you've been searching for. Humbledbudget.com is a personal finance and educational website with a great variety of topics when it comes to budgeting, taxes, investing, and the popular topic of FIRE, financial independence, retire early. Humbledbudget.com has a goal, and that's to help you reach your financial dreams, no matter what your goals are when it comes to finances. It doesn't matter where you start, where you come from, or where you are right now. HumbledBudget.com can help. What are you waiting for? Take that first step to the financial life you've dreamed of and go to HumbledBudget.com. That's HumbledBudget. HumbledBudget.com.
All right. Again, welcome to the show, guys. You're listening to VRL. That's Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio. And I am your host, Dini. Our interviews are designed to go beyond music, news, books, art, acting, films, technology, education, entrepreneurship, entertainment, and sometimes even past that thing that we call the ego. Our interviews are designed to go behind the scenes and into the minds of these incredible human beings. You know, the ones who are out there giving it their all for me, for you, and for the world. Well, 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 here we are once again. Ladies and gentlemen, prepare to ride the wave of nostalgia with the modern twist. We have the sensational Canadian rock band Heatstroke in the studio, ready to rock your senses. From the gritty streets of Brownsville, New York, to the iconic Times Square, their music takes us on a journey through time with their debut LP. It's called Empire Statement, known for electrifying performances and a sound that echoes the legends of rock with the fresh pop sensibility. Heatstroke is the name of every rock. Well, is the name, and it should be on every listener's. Should be. That's the call to action. With that, let's welcome them to the show. Hello, hello, hello. Heatstroke, welcome.
Hello. Hey, how's it going?
Pretty good. How's it going for you?
Oh, we're doing great. Glad to be on.
All right, cool deal. Who all do we have?
So I got Hunter, I'm bass player. Troy Kirkwood, play drums.
I'm Orion Anderson, singer.
Daniel Beaton, guitar.
All right, all right. Welcome, welcome, Heatstroke. It's fantastic to have you guys here. Starting off, guys, can you tell us about the creative spark that, you know, fused and ignited Empire Statement? And kind of what it means for you as a band, you know, to share this story.
All right. So, yeah. So, with the creative spark for this album, when the band formed, we formed in October of 2021. We started doing a few covers, but then we realized that to get anywhere, we've got to do our own stuff. So, what I had, this is Troy Kirkwood talking. I don't know if we need the names at all, but we had had a couple of songs written with certain lyrics from before we were a band, and we knew that some of them like weren't quite strong enough. And so the melodies were good, but the overall way we went about it was we scrapped pretty much all the lyrics we had. And I knew something that I wanted to do because some of my absolute favorite albums of all time are concept albums. Genesis, Lamb Lies Down on Broadway is one that comes to mind. Was to write a similar concept album with a theme that carries out throughout the whole record. So in late December of 21 through April, the writing process of the whole album commenced. And I wrote about New York because it's really the most fascinating place on earth for me. There's so many things that go on. There's so many landmarks. And I know that when you look at the album, every single song landmark is exemplified and shown throughout the work. So really just honoring the place that I love the most was what sparked me to write those lyrics. And we started recording in July, and then what we've got just recently is the finished product, so glad everyone can hear it now.
Yeah, anyone want to add to that?
I don't think so.
Wasn't, I guess, any other way to say it.
Well, this month, we've been talking about trying something new, and especially things that, you know, kind of either help spark some creativity or that pushes you beyond a comfort zone or something that's just helping you become successful even more every day. So in the spirit of trying new things, when was the last time each one of you tried something new or ventured into uncharted territory, whether that was musically or just anything in life?
It's Hunter here. I recently just had a first kickboxing fight. It's pretty new to me. It was a good experience, and really made me feel good about trying new things in general. Very, very, very different. I ended up winning, so that created a little spark within me to keep going. It was pretty cool in that sense.
Pretty dope, man. Award.
For Troy, for something new, could say that I was... I don't know if we want to go which route we want to go here for something new. I don't know how much I want to say, but we're gonna go ahead and say in the songwriting world that I've written something that's not in your classic 4/4, 6/8 time for the first time. I don't even know what time signature it could be, but it's probably something similar to 5/4, but the it's really just a drumming progression right now, but I'm really hoping to expand on it in the future, and I think that we'll see that in the near future.
Yeah, everyone gets an odd time for the trip now.
Yeah,
I guess for Orion here, I recently hosted a Halloween party, and
good work.
I had a rap battle with a friend. I mean, that, I'm a rock star, not a rapper.
Cool.
For Daniel, this isn't super recent, but I mean, I moved away from home, and that's like still new, so that's definitely a lot different.
Yeah. Cool deal. All right, Orion, your voice, that's a cool name, by the way. It's like, you have to
be. I appreciate it, man. Thank you.
Yeah. With a name like Orion, it's like, oh, yeah, I got to be a rock star, right?
Exactly.
But your voice has been described as rich and evocative. How did you cultivate your vocal style?
So, I grew up listening to, like, just kind of what everyone would. I was born in 2003, so it's listening to stuff my mom would listen to. She was into that kind of early 2000s rock and stuff like that. But one of the driving factors, I'd say, for my voice, the thing that really got me into music fully, I grew up really, really loving Michael Jackson. And I just loved the way that he had just that flow and a little bit of funk to his style, right? And then, you know, as I grew up, I got more into Bruno Mars, and even now at this point in time in my life, now that we're really getting into the rock scene, it's you know, I listen to kind of the older music, so Sam Cooke, and it's all over the place, actually. So Sam Cooke, and even I draw a little bit of inspiration from David Lee Roth from Van Halen. And then I just kind of tried to figure out a way that it would work and it could flow all well and as one kind of, as myself, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Very cool. Troy, man.
It's worth noting, too, that this guy took, like, two lessons lifetime. That's all him.
Oh, man. That is definitely incredible. So, yeah, Troy, man, could you tell us about the dream that inspired Broadway and, you know, how you were able to
that
experience into a song? Like, how did you...
Pardon me? Say the last bit again.
Say that again?
I just missed the last part of what you asked. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, that's it.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so that dream, damn. All I can say is that I don't remember any of the visions in the dream. I don't remember what I was doing. But I remember waking up, and I remember the clock said 3:23 a.m. And cold sweat, just shaking, and having this this melody in my head that I just couldn't get out. And it was funny because I didn't want to wake anyone in the house up at the time. It was written, what, 3-4 years ago. My parents were sleeping. And I go into my phone, go into the notes app, and I'm like really quietly trying to go da-da-da-da-da-da, just trying to remember it for the next day, right? And next day, like, first thing when I woke up, I remember waking up early, too. It was 7 or 8 o'clock in the morning, whatever it was. And going on the bass and just working out the notes. I was like, okay, I've got something here. I've got something that that is definitely going to be fun to play. And then the lyrics are really funny because my mom actually had a dream, too, about something similar to, like, stealing an ambulance and, like, driving away and her saying, it's working. And that was all she told me. And then I just wrote the lyrics, just dumb lyrics, but at the same time, a lot of fun about, and it made it tie into the album. But yeah, that's all I can tell you about my dream.
Really good question, man.
Thanks. So, Hobart, as the bass player, how do you ensure that your bass lines contribute to the storytelling in, you know, Heatstroke song?
So a little acote, a little bit. When we first formed the band, I was still in college, but I still had a lot of work to do. I was in engineering school, so I actually stepped out of the band, and they kept going as a three-piece for a bit, and that's actually when they wrote pretty much everything, most of it, all of it. And then they started gigging, and my school was done, and I was going to support my friends, and eventually ended up back in the band, and having to relearn all the songs, I was sort of told, like, hey, put your own little... just put your sound into what we're doing. Like, I don't want you to just do what we're doing, because we want you to be you. So what what I did was we sort of had a weird little basement mix on Spotify, and I listened to that forever. Terrible quality, but the music was there. And what I did was I just played along with my eyes closed until it just felt right. And once I had something for every song, rehearsals, I just showed up, I played exactly that, heard nothing, also heard compliments, and I thought, perfect, that's what I did. There's lots of parts in the album where you hear noises or quotes different instruments that aren't like in your typical rock band sort of thing. Like in one track, it sounds like there's a clarinet. That's actually all bass. And I just felt like I needed to do it for just to add to the music. Like at the beginning of Brooklyn, that big weird trippy song.
Desmond's Trip, yeah.
Desmond's Trip, yeah. It was just a little bass solo throughout the whole thing, made it sound like a clarinet, and just thought it fit and it needed to be there. Lots of little stuff like that if you really listen to the bass throughout the whole album.
Yeah. Wow. All right. So Daniel, what was the process like to integrate Sail Me Away into the album's narrative? You know, how does it complement the overall theme?
Sorry, what was that last part?
Yeah, just asking, you know, how does Sail Me Away complement the theme of the album?
So Sail Me Away was it was written like a year or two before I actually even met these guys. But I brought it up to Troy and Orion at practice when we were still like writing our own original music. The album was kind of still not pieced together yet. And we heard it, I shared the lyrics, and then Troy actually was like, yo, this could be a sick song to put at, like, the end of the concept album. And we worked it out, and we just think just what it's about, how the song starts and ends is just a perfect...
The hero's journey, right? You were saying.
Yeah. It was written about the hero's journey. The song was really written for my dad, so I was hoping it would go just onto like a random... normal, not concept album before I met these guys. But yeah, it just happened to work out that way. I didn't write it for the album at all. It
flowed.
It flowed perfectly, yeah.
Right. Well, guys, we're going to jump into some music. We have Times Square Claire, and then we'll be back.
Oh, yes.
More Heatstroke. Thank you.
Saw you standing across the street, where my poor heart melted. Don't have to believe in love at first sight if you did or felt it. Just a Brooklyn teenage boy, too cautious to say hello. Then my hour was done, you were up and gone. Claire, where did the town go? Are you safe? Are you scared? Are you doing all right? There's some
welcome back. And guys, that was Times Square Claire. Oh man, what a dope, awesome song. Let's go ahead and bring them back. Heatstroke.
For those guys, that was pretty good.
Yeah, man, I was over here rocking, man. Pretty good song. So the album released on October the 20th, and you guys had a chance to perform at the Lounge. How did it go?
That was a great show. I think because we were all excited that it's finally released and people could listen to it. Not that we don't usually, but I think we put extra heart into our playing that night and really had as much fun as we could have to really try and connect with the audience and be as likable as possible. We all had a great turnout, I think.
The thing was, too, is that us as a band, we play up. When there's something going on, when our moods are up, when there's more people out, we just rise to the occasion. And there was a lot of people out, and we were all feeling really good. So it was a kind of a perfect storm for us to have a good show, and it was a lot of fun. One of my favorites so far.
Oh, yeah. You can see that venue, too. It's, like, really small. So when there's a lot of people there, and it's just, like, really loud.
It's a fire hazard. Oh, yeah.
Nice. Where can our listeners connect with you guys online?
So we have on all major social media platforms, we all have accounts. So you can find us on Instagram at official.heatstroke, on Facebook, just Heatstroke.
Our website.
Our website, official.
Officialheatstroke.com.
Yeah. We have Spotify, Apple Music under Heatstroke as well, YouTube Music. Find us everywhere.
We're all over the place.
Started a TikTok account too.
We just
recently started TikTok.
I'm getting on that trend.
Guys, just in case you need those links, I will have them in the description of this episode and in the show notes.
Nice.
All you guys have to do is just click those links. I want to send a massive thank you to the powerhouse that is Heatstroke. Thank you guys for sharing your passion, your stories, and the Making of Empire statement. And for those listening,
thank you so much.
Be sure to catch the full album. That is the call to action. Grab it. I don't know if I should shout out Spotify or not because they're doing
it.
No,
it's up to you.
Teaser is offering twice as much if you can reach 1,000 screens. So, go Deezer, go iTunes.
Yeah, we are on those two.
Good. So, keep your eyes peeled and ears open for more Heatstroke. They're just warming up, I believe. And until next time, keep the record spinning and the spirit of rock alive. Thank you so much, guys. I truly appreciate your time spending it here with me, Hunter, Orion, Troy, and Daniel. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having us.
And Hunter.
I said thanks first.
He said
first. Yeah. Oh, well, I forgot that. I heard three.
Yeah. Hunter did not say that.
Cool. All right, guys. Thank you and have a blessed night. Thank you.
Yeah, you as well. Rock on.
Hey there. Do you love podcasts? Are you having difficulty finding the right ones to listen to? Is it frustrating when you're trying to pick that show? You know, the one where everyone must collectively agree on? Like finding a good movie or TV show to watch, do you look for the most jam-packed entertainment that's possible to find in a single episode every week? Then search no more. And welcome to J&J Production Studios. It's our business to provide the best entertainment and information available for you. Whether you're sitting in that comfy chair with your favorite snack and beverage listening live each week, or downloading your favorite show episodes to take with you on the go while you're at work, exercising, or even just to play at night for you to fall asleep to. There's something for everyone, no matter what size, shape, or age you are. Visit www.linktree.com/J_J Production Studios to find all the streaming services where our podcast shows can be found. You can also connect with us on your favorite social media platforms, including Facebook and Twitter. You can join our public Discord server and chat directly with us. But wait, there's more. You can subscribe to our official YouTube channel and be notified every time a new show is broadcast. Wish you could have some studio souvenirs or collectibles? Guess what? You can. Visit the official store where you can purchase items featuring your favorite podcast and show hosts. Would you like to help support us? You can do that by getting your very own exclusive membership on our Patreon account. All proceeds go to help us upgrade our shows, which will only enhance the entertainment provided to you. Thank you so much. We're excited to have you as an audience. Your love and support are always appreciated. We'll see you soon.
Hey, what's going on, guys? Be sure to tune in today. All sorts of fun and excitement that will keep you entertained wherever you are. J&J Production Studios, your number one home for entertainment.
Thank you, my Vigilantes family, as always, for checking out my podcast over here at Vigilantes Radio Live. All episodes are available for free download, and you can grab it from either Spreaker.com/Only One Media Group, Spotify, CastBox, iHeartRadio, iTunes, YouTube, the app Podcast Addict, or over at our website, which again is onlyonemediagroup.com. And that goes for every single show that we've ever aired. If you like to request music or send something for me to play, email it to vradio@onlyonemediagroup.com. That is V as in Victor. And here's my disclaimer. We are genre free. We do not judge, and we absolutely do not base our opinions on hearsay, but facts alone. And actually, scratch all of that, because all of my opinions are always right. That's the bottom line. This is my show, so deal with it. Just kidding. On behalf of myself, Denny, I appreciate all you guys for tuning in, either afterwards or live with us. Spread the word, because sharing is caring. We stepped up our game just for you guys and our guests to make sure that you have the best experience here on our show. Be sure to connect with me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, Snapchat, TikTok, and all social media sites, as well as Spreaker, YouTube. We always follow back. Okay, well, just remember to put yourself into everything that you do and never stop investing in yourself. Peace, love, grilled cheese, and talk with you later.
You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, the people's choice for quality interviews, art, music, and hot topics. Hosted by Demetrius Whodini-Blak Reynolds of the duo No Longer The Hero. All episodes of this podcast are available for free download at www.onlyonemediagroup.com. This is a Seventh Sign Regime, Rebirth Worldwide Syndicate exclusive.